YouTubers. I haven't done a favorites video for such a long time, so I thought it's time to do my current or fall favorites for this year. Let's start with face products. My current favorite foundation is the NARS in medium 1 Punjab. It's the Sheer Glow foundation. This foundation is perfect for fall because it's a little bit glowy and I'm not as tanned and not as light either, so this is the perfect color match and the perfect foundation at the moment, or for fall now for me. Even though I have the problem with my oily skin, I really do like this Sheer Glow foundation. Underneath, I'm still using my MAC mattifying cream. I've been using it all summer and I still like it a lot, and I'm gonna finish this up and let's see what I'm gonna use next as a primer. As a concealer, still love the MAC Pro Longwear. I tried the Clinique All About Eyes concealer, but I have to say I love just this one a lot more because it has really good coverage and I use it for my face and under eyes. To set that with a powder, I really love the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in Natural, the medium plus. Unfortunately, I already hit pan on it because I really do like this powder. So these are my go-to face products. Let's move on to bronzer. I have here one bronzer from Manhattan. It was a limited edition. It's the Luxopolis Bronzing Powder 92F. It's very similar to the NARS, which is my second favorite bronzer, to the NARS Laguna. I wouldn't say it's a dupe, but they are similar. And I love both of them. They are shimmery and not that dark, so really, really nice bronzers. And of course, there has to be a matte bronzer as well. The Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. This is just a matte bronzer. Really like it as well for my draw line here, because I don't like to put shimmery bronzers here and down my neck. So this is the matte Chocolate Soleil, Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzing powder. Nice collection of bronzers here, shimmery ones, a matte one. All you will ever need to contour or bronze up your face. Because of my oily skin, I didn't do so much highlighting in summer and I really, really missed it. And these are the two go-to products at the moment. I love, just love, the Hush Cream Color Base by MAC. Looks like this. I just apply it, take my finger and apply it on my cheekbones. I'm wearing it today also. And I put the Chez Chez La Mer from the Champagne collection over it. So these two are my go-to highlighting products. Next we come to my favorite products in makeup, the blushes. Of course, the NARS blushes, and for fall, this Arverde blush is a really, really nice blush. Oh, and one e.l.f. blush. This is again a very nice fall color. The first blush is the NARS Sin. There is no particular order which one I like the most. Just like them all for fall. This is a very nice shimmery lilac color. Next one is Exhibit A. And it looks like this. Wow! It's one of the most pigmented blushes from NARS. And you have to be really careful wearing that blush. It's a really, really beautiful color for autumn. So that was the Exhibit A. Next, because I want to move on with the reddish tone blushes, I show you the Alverde. It's the Flamingo, the powder blush Flamingo. And let's swatch it next to the Exhibit A. There you go, this is the Flamingo blush. It's like the MAC Sheer Tone blush, is this Flamingo blush. And definitely one you can layer because it's sheer. And I'd like to mention, whenever I use that Flamingo blush, I always took the Manhattan bronzer and was wearing these two together, because this was just a really nice combination. These two products together, they look so nice on the skin. While I'm at it, let me swatch the Laguna bronzer next to the Manhattan bronzer, so you can see the comparison of those two. This is the Manhattan and this is the Laguna. They have both this nice shimmer in it, and the Manhattan is a little bit darker than the Laguna bronzer. In fall, there has to be a neutral blush as well. This is the Doucer from NARS. Here is the NARS Doucer. Here is the swatch. Very nice matte neutral toned blush. Now here is my e.l.f. blush, which I really, really liked for fall. It's a very nice fall color. It's the Berry Mary. This is again a shimmery blush with a little bit of glitter in it, but no, not really chunky glitter. And again, a very nice mauve color. Here is it. And actually it looks a bit like the NARS Sin. Here is the Sin. The Sin is a little bit more lavender and a little bit lighter than the Berry Mary here. As you can see, I'm following the fall-autumn trend are plummy, lilac-y and neutral blushes. These mauve-toned colors, as you can see here on my hand. Now let's move on to the eye products. Always and Forever, my Urban Decay Primer Potion, the original one. Yes. My go-to mascara is the CoverGirl Lash Blast Volume. I've been using this mascara such a long time now, for about a year. And in summer I take the waterproof, and in winter I'm using the regular mascara. And this is the brush. I just absolutely love these huge brushes. Then my favorite fall eyeshadows, again from MAC, of course. And I'm rediscovering colors that I haven't been using in summer that much. So here is the one. This is Swiss Chocolate and Sketch. And of course, Satin Taupe and All That Glitters, these two. And in my second palette, my go-to fall colors are here the Bronze, the Greens, the Humid and the Sumptuous Olive. Then the Amber Lights, which I really, really like, which I have on my lid today. And Cork, Espresso and Prune. There is really one outstanding color to me for fall. It's the Club eyeshadow. It's a duochromed eyeshadow. Really like this color for fall. And Handwritten. And oh my god, I just love all of them. And of course the Carbon. Oh, what can I tell you? And for eyeliner, I love to use these two little pots. This is the Dark Diversion Fluid Line and the Avenue Fluid Line. I have to say the Avenue almost a little bit more than the Dark Diversion. These were the two fluid lines from the MAC Me Over collection. At the moment I'm not that much into black eyeliner. These two are really, really nice alternatives. So here is Avenue and here is Dark Diversion. This is a bit of a plummy color and this is a dark brown color with golden sparkles in it. And I have one drugstore also from Essence. It's the London Baby, the 02 London Baby. It's a very, very dark brown eyeliner. The most used eyeliner pencils for my waterline are the Urban Decay 24/7 pencils. The one is Mildew and the other one is Dash. I absolutely like the greens in my waterline for fall. This is the Dash and this is the Mildew. There are three lipsticks which I absolutely adore currently. The first one I will show you is one by MAC. It's the Kinda Sexy. And it looks like that. This is just a perfect color. It's not my currently love, it's my all-time favorite. Because with almost every look you can wear this color. Here's the swatch. This is the lipstick. Next lipstick is a Dior lipstick. It's a brown tone with gold sparkles in it. It's from the Dior Addict High Shine line. It's the number 420, the Mordor, or however you pronounce it, because I think it's French. So here is the color. And here is the swatch. This is a very sheer lipstick. It's very, very moisturizing. And the last lipstick which I really liked is the one from Guerlain. This is the Giovanna 67. And the packaging is just adorable. With the little mirror in it. And this is the color. And I don't have to swatch this because I'm wearing it on my lips today. And there are two lip glosses which I have been enjoying a lot. These are the, one is the Cream Sheen Gloss from MAC and one is a Pro Longwear Lip Gloss from MAC. And the Cream Sheen is the Natural Flare. This is this one. So this is the swatch, this is the lip gloss. And this one is a Pro Longwear Lip Gloss. And this color is just the perfect lip gloss color for me. I'm wearing this lip gloss just with a lip liner and that's it. And it lasts really a long time. Very, very nice lip gloss. The Pro Longwear lip glosses are quite sticky. So if you don't like sticky lip glosses, I would skip on that. But I don't mind it, so it's my favorite. I'm always using my MAC Fix Plus. Funny enough, in summer I forgot to use it because I had it in a drawer and I didn't think about it. I think my makeup lasts a bit longer. Another very nice rediscovered product. And I'm happy. Now I show you my favorite fall nail polishes because I'm a little bit of a nail polish junkie. Again, one rediscovered item, the Chanel Particulière. This I think is just the perfect fall winter color. So here it is, the Chanel Particulière. And my sister sits behind the camera and she will show you the swatch. Give me your finger. Hi everyone, I'm behind the scenes today. So this is it. And next one is of course a dark color again, because I'm really enjoying dark colors in winter and fall. This is the OPI. Cuckoo for this color. I don't have a swatch of these at the moment. Sorry. I'm wearing today a very dark blue nail color. It's a Catrice. I don't know the name. I will link you the nail polish collection video in the down bar below. Also the NARS blush collection video. There you can see the swatches in its true color. If you're interested in it, click below. And of course there has to be my perfume, the Little Miss Dior. I love it. This is not particular a winter or a fall favorite. This is my all-time favorite. I really love this fragrance. My little kid Antonio was in the hospital. He had an operation and I spent the time with him in the hospital. So for keeping my head up, my brother-in-law treated me. He bought me this perfume. So thank you so much, Andy. I really appreciate it. These are my current or fall autumn favorites. If you want to see this look I'm wearing today, here is the link for the tutorial, because this is one of my favorite autumn fall looks. And this concludes my favorite video. Hope you liked it. So have a nice day. Love you all. Bye from Brigitte. Bye.